Welcome, friend. Again, we have to discuss our subject, several variable calculus. In the previous lecture, we solved some problems of finding critical points and so maximum and minimum values of a function f of x, y, z, or a function we can say. In the today's lecture, again we have to find the maximum and minimum values, but we have to use here different method, and this method is a Lagrange multiplier method. So today we have to discuss the method of Lagrange multiplier, and we have to solve some problem by using this. So we start our method, that is the Lagrange's method of Lagrange multiplier. Method of Lagrange's multiplier. So in the previous lecture also we solve or we find the maximum and minimum values of the function, and here by this method also we have to find the maximum and minimum value. So what we have to write here, to find the maximum and minimum values of f of x, y, z subject to the constraint g of x, y, z is equal to k. Here we are assuming that the extreme values of f of x, y, z exist, and gradient of g is not equal to 0 on the surface g of x, y, z is equal to k. So what we write here, that is we have to find the maximum and minimum value of a function subject to the constraint, or we can say surface, a g of x, y, z is equal to k. Here what we assume, that is extreme values are exist and this gradient of g is not equal to 0. So what is this concept? This is gradient of g. So what should be the definition? Gradient of g, it is equal to gxi plus gyj plus gzk. This is nothing but the definition of a gradient of a g. That is first partial derivative into I, second partial derivative into j and k. This is our gradient vector, we can say. Okay, so this is gradient of g is not equal to 0. Gradient of g is not equal to 0 on the surface g of x, y, z is equal to k. So what are the steps? First, what is first step? Find the values. Find the values of x, y, z and lambda such that. So what we have to do in the first step, we have to find the values of x, y, z, lambda such that what? Gradient of f of x, y, z, it is equal to lambda gradient of g of x, y, z, or you can write only gradient of f is equal to lambda gradient of z. And what we have written, that is what we have given, g of x, y, z is equal to k. You have to find the values of x, y, z and lambda by using these two equations. Okay, then in the second step, evaluate all values of f at point x, y, z. At point x, y, z. So, evaluate value of f at point x, y, z. And then what we say? Then the largest value of f is maximum and smallest value is minimum value of f. So these are the two steps. So what is method of Lagrange? First you have to find that is the maximum and minimum value of f of x, y, z subject to the constraint g of x, y, z is equal to k. Here what we assume that is extreme values exist and this gradient of g is not equal to 0. This gradient of g is not equal to 0 means this vector g is not equal to 0, that is gx is not equal to 0, gy is not equal to 0 and gz is not equal to 0, or you can say all these are not equal to 0. If all these are 0, then we can say that the gradient of g is 0. And then what we have to write then, find the values of x, y, z by using these two conditions and then evaluate. We are getting here x, y, z point. Find all f at each and every point, at all values of f at x, y, z, at point x, y, z. The largest value of f is the largest value is the maximum and the smallest value is the minimum value of f. So find value, you can say find value of f at each point. You can write like this also. Find, evaluate value of f at each point x, y, z. You are getting some values. Among these, the maximum value is, that is the largest value is the maximum and the smallest value is the minimum value in minimum value of f. If you write this equation, it is in the components. If we write the vector equation in the component form, that is gradient of f of x, y, z, it is equal to what you can write here, gradient of g of x, y, z, and here is what, lambda. So what is the component of this, or what is the gradient of this? Is fxi plus fyj plus fzk, and it is equal to what, lambda into, it is equal to what, gxi plus gyj plus gzk. And if you just do the simplification, then what you are getting, it is in the left side no change. Did do multiplication to the or do simple solve the bracket, then you are getting lambda gxi plus lambda gyj plus lambda gzk. And if you equating the coefficient of ijk, what you are getting, equating the coefficient of ijk, then fx is equal to lambda gx, fy is equal to lambda gy, and fz is equal to lambda gz. And we have one more condition, that is g of x, y, z. And we have one more condition, that is g of x, y, z is equal to k. It is equal to k. Now what you are getting here, what you are getting, you are getting a four equations, you are getting a four equation, and how much variables, x, y, z and lambda, these are the four variables there. So we have a system of equation. How much equations? 4 equations with 4 variables. Hence we get a system of equation of 4 equations. System of 4 equations with 4 variables. For variable x, y, z and lambda. So you can solve this system of equation and you are able to find the value of x, y, z and lambda. But it is not necessary to find value of lambda in explicit form. So value of lambda in explicit form it is not necessary to find. So what we did here, just we are writing the equations, vector equation, it is in the component form and you are getting this 4 conditions or 4 equations or system of equation, 4 equations. Okay, so when we are solving the problem, we are not writing each and every step this, directly we are considering these 4 equations. Okay, so do keep in mind these 4 equations. So getting the method of Lagrange, this method of Lagrange's multiplier we write for 3 variables. It is we are written for 3 variables function. Of 3 variable, if you have to write this equation, this method of Lagrange multiplier for 2 variable, then what will be the change? Just I am giving the change, that is f of xy subject to the constraint. Here also you are getting only g of xy is equal to k, assuming that this all is same. Here is what, again xy is equal to k. Now find the values of xy and here xy and lambda such that this you can erase here z. Okay, so you can write this method similar for the 2 variable function also. So here again evaluate the values of f at each point xy, at each point xy the largest value of f is called as the maximum and the minimum it is for the smallest value. Then if you write it is in the component form, then here should be the this only, then here is only fxi plus fyj is equal to lambda into what, lambda gxi in plus gyj, and here this third step or third term is not there, then here is not a k, that is now equating the coefficient of ij, then you are getting only the 3 equations, not a fourth one. That is you are getting only the 3 equations, fx lambda x, fx lambda gx, fy lambda gy and g of xy is equal to k. Hence the we get the system of how much equations now? It is 3 equations, system of 3 equations with the 3 variables, with the 3 variables xy and lambda. So method of Lagrange multiplier you can write for the 2 variable function also very easily. Now we will go for the problem on this. Okay, so we will solve a first problem. So what is the first problem? A rectangular box without a lid is to made from the 12 meter square of cardboard. Find the maximum volume of such a box. So if you see this problem is similar, that is which solve it is in a previous lecture. Now this problem we have to solve or we have to find the maximum volume by using Lagrange's multiplier method. That is we solve it is by using a first and second derivative test in the previous lecture. Similar problem we have to solve by using the Lagrange's method of Lagrange's multiplier. So if in exam this question is asked like this, you can solve by any method. But if it is given, solve it by Lagrange method, then you have to go by this method only. Okay, so what is given? A rectangular box with a lid, without a lid is to made. Without a lid means what? Suppose we have any rectangular box, that is, already we discussed these things. You have a rectangular box, and if this rectangular box already, this is the rectangular box. Suppose this is our X, this is our Y, and this is our Z. That is, X is the width, Y is the length, and Z is the height of the rectangular box. So what we can write here, let X, Y, Z are the width, length and height of the rectangular box respectively. What it means? X is the width, Y is the length, and Z is the height of the box. So what we have to find? We have to find the volume. So let V be the volume of such a box, then what we are getting? V is equal to, that is, V is the length into width into the LBH, that is, the formula is LBH, that is our X, Y and Z, product of the, that is, width into height into the length. So this is our volume, and all these dimension we are considering, it is in meter, because we have given this is the unit, that is 12 meter square, therefore all the dimensions are must in a meter. So volume now we are finding, and what is this 12 meter square of a cardboard? Meter square means you have given a area, but what is given here? Given a rectangular box without a lid, that means it has not a upper face, it upper face is not covered here. That means you have to take only the, how much faces are there here? 6 faces are there, and you have to assume only the 5 faces, not a 6. That is 1, 2, 3, 4 and upper and lower 6. But here is a without lid, that is, you have to accept or you have to remove the one face. So what is surface area? A surface area of what? Surface area of a rectangular box is how much? 12 meter square. Therefore what you are getting? You are getting this, that is 2 into XZ. Which part is removed? That is, first is removed, that is, only one XY is there. It is, you have given 12, 2XZ plus 2YZ. Okay, so you have written a surface area of this. Now, we are saying this is equal to the F, or this is our V of XYZ, and if you take, this is our G of XYZ. Now what we have to do? We have to maximize V of XYZ is equal to XYZ subject to constraint, which constraint? G of XYZ is equal to 12. Now what we have to use? We have to use the Lagrange's multiplier method. That is by the method of Lagrange's. Lagrange's method of Lagrange's multiplier. We have to find x, y, z and lambda. Okay, x, y, z and lambda. For this, consider what we have to consider. Gradient v is equal to the lambda gradient of g. Lambda gradient of g. Then we get equations. We get equations. Which equations we are getting? It is Vx is equal to lambda Gx, Vy is equal to lambda Gy, and Vz is equal to what? Lambda V, Gz, and we have, and G of x, y, z is equal to 12. It is equal to 12. Then we get. So what we are getting? Find Vx here. What is our V of V? X, Y, Z. That is X into Y into Z. Find Vx. What you are getting only? Y, Z is equal to lambda. What is our Gx? What is our Gx here? 2 into Gx. Gx means derivative of a function G with respect to X. It is 2Z. Plus y. You can write it is 2z plus y. What will be, they say this is equation number 1. Now what we have to find next? Now if suppose you are taking now Vy is equal to lambda Gy. So what is Vy? Derivative of V with respect to Y? It is xz is equal to lambda into 2, what is now? Here Gy. So here is the first term is no Y, so it is 0. So this is 2z plus x. 2z plus x. Say it is equation number 2. Now we have to go for next, that is Vz. So what is Vz here? It is now Vz is xy only. Xy it is equal to. Xy it is equal to what we are getting here. This is 2x. Here is 0. It is a 2y and here is a 0. So what is the our lambda into what? Lambda into what? 2x plus 2y. 2x plus 2y. Say this is equation number 3. And what is our g of x, y, z? That is our 2xz plus 2yz plus xy is equal to 12. This is equation number 4. So after this, what we did here, just we write this, we convert this theory example. It is in the equation form. We find our first function v of x, y, z. Then we find our second function, that is the second constraint. We can say this is nothing but g of x, y, z. And now we use here a method of Lagrange's multiplier. And in this method, what we have to consider? You have to consider the vector equation. Then you are getting the three equation, and here is a one more condition constraint. So four equations. Just we are finding the partial derivatives. Vx, Vy, Vz, Gx, Gy, Gz, and we put this one, it is into the equation, and now we are getting the four equation. So there is not a specific method to find the or to solve this method. We can say there is not a specific method to solve or to find the values of x, y, z and lambda. You have to observe this and you have to think how you can solve this. But it is in this case, if you see here, if you multiply equation number 1 by x, 2 by y and 3 by z, then you are getting our LHS are x, y, z. That is equation number 1, 2 and 3 all have a same LHS, that is X, Y, Z. And then by considering the 2 equations, you can solve easily or you can find the values of X, Y easily. Okay, so now we do these things. So what we have to do now, you have to multiply equation number 1 by X, equation number 2 by Y. So I write this, multiply equation 1 by X, 2 by Y and 3 by Z, we get. What we are getting it is X, Y, Z is equal to X, lambda, X, 2, Z plus Y. Okay, or you can do multiply here inside the bracket, then what we are getting here, 2 X, Z plus Y, X, Y. This is equation number 5. Now multiply equation 2 by Y, so X, Y, Z is equal to lambda 2 Y, Z plus X, Y. Say this is equation number 6. Now multiply equation number 3 by Z, so it is X, Y, Z. It is equal to lambda 2 X, Z plus 2 Y, Z. This is equation number what? How much it is? Equation number 7. It is equation number 7, and we have a equation number 4 also. Okay, there is no need to multiply this. So what we can say now, if we take this lambda is 0, if we take lambda is equal to 0, then what you are getting here, if this lambda is 0, then what you are getting, yz is equal to 0, xz is equal to 0, xy is equal to 0. Then if this all this 0, then what we are getting, your surface area is 0. That means what? This is a contradiction to our equation number 4. It is not a getting 12. Then what we are getting, yz is equal to xz is equal to xy, it is equal to 0, which is contradiction to by equation what? 1, 2 and 3, which is contradiction to equation 4, because if this both all are 0, therefore this and this are 0, then it is not equal to 12. Okay, so hence what we can say, hence lambda must be not equal to 0. Lambda must be not equal to 0. Now consider two equations and try to find the value of X, Y, Z. So from equation 5 and 6, what we are getting? These both are equal, therefore this lambda is lambda into 2xz plus xy, it is equal to lambda into 2yz plus xy. And now lambda is non-zero, therefore lambda will get cancelled. And what is remaining here? So you can write this lambda will get cancelled, and this is 2xz plus xy is equal to 2yz plus xy. Now you can say this xy get cancelled, and therefore xz is equal to, or you can write xz is equal to what? Xz is equal to yz. And if you take, this implies that what we can say, xz minus yz is equal to 0. And if you take common, that is z, x minus y is equal to 0. And what it implies? This implies z is equal to 0 or x minus y is equal to 0. But if z is equal to 0, then what you are getting? Our volume x, y, z, it is equal to 0. Therefore, xy is equal to 0. This is contradiction. This implies what? Z must be not equal to 0. Therefore, our x minus y must be 0, and this implies that x is equal to y. So, from equation number 5 and 6, you are getting x is equal to y. Similarly, you can find from equation number 6 and 7, what you are getting here again? Again, you can write here, that is lambda into 2yz plus xy, it is equal to lambda into 2xz plus 2yz. Now this lambda get cancelled. So 2yz plus xy, 2yz plus xy, it is equal to 2xz plus 2yz. So this 2yz get cancel, and now what is remaining here 2xz plus xy is equal to minus xy, it is equal to 0. Now take common, what should be the common here? X is common, so 2z minus y is equal to 0. So what we can say, therefore x is equal to 0, or what we can write here, y is equal to 2z, that is bracket is this, therefore y is equal to 2z. But what, again you can write, if x is equal to 0, then our volume is 0, and hence x is not, must be non-zero, and this implies that our y is equal to 2z. Say this is equation number 7 or 8, and this is equation number 9. Because equation number 7 and equation number 9. Then from equation 8 and 9, what you can write from equation 8 and 9? What you are getting from equation 8 and 9? What you are getting here? X is equal to y is equal to 2z. X is equal to y is equal to 2z. So put these values, put the value x is equal to 2z and y is equal to 2z in equation, which equation you can say? 4, equation number 4. So what you are getting here? What is our equation number 4? It is what? 2xz plus 2yz plus xy, it is equal to what? 12. This is equation number 4. So what we are getting here? Yeah, so we can write here 2 into 2z into what? 2z plus 2z into 2z plus 2z into 2z. It is equal to 12, and what should be the answer here? 4z square is equal to 12, and therefore what we are getting here? 4 how much? 12z square is equal to 12, and therefore z square is equal to 1, and therefore z is equal to what? Plus minus 1. But what is z? Z is height. Hence, it can't be negative. It can't be negative, and therefore z must be what? Positive. Therefore, z is equal to 1. And therefore, z is equal to 1. Then what we are getting? Therefore, put this equation here. Therefore, x is equal to y is equal to 2z. And it is equal to 2 into 1. This should be 2. What dimension you are getting here? X is equal to y is equal to n. Z is equal to, therefore what you are getting? Therefore x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2, and z is equal to 1. So we are getting the dimension of the rectangular box, and these similar dimensions we are getting that time also. that time also. Then what we have to find? We have to maximize the, or we have to find the maximum volume. Then the maximum volume V is. So what is V? V is equal to x, y, z. It is equal to 2 into 2 into 1. Therefore, V is equal to what? 4 meter cube. And this is the similar answer which find it is in a previous lecture by using the second derivative test. That is different method. Thus, what we can say, thus the required maximum volume is 4 meter cube. And this is end of the problem. So definitely the length of the problem is long, or there is a lengthy problem, but method is very simple. You have to just consider the vector equation, compare the coefficients of the both side, and you have a one surface. Then you are getting the four equation. That is the system of four equation in four variables. And by observing this, you have to solve, or you have to find the values of x, y, z. This is very important, and then you have to maximize, minimize. That is what is given. Think on this and try to solve the problems like this. So this problem is again very important. The method can be asked for 2 marks, or this method can be asked for 5 marks with example. So do practice for solving the more problems. So we will take few more problems, or we take more problem in the next lecture. So today we will stop here. Thank you very much.